Hello guys and welcome back to Crypto Bull. In this video we will talk about a couple of subjects. We will talk about Bitcoin and the Bitcoin is in danger zone. On Bitcoin long chart we are clearly in danger zone and I will tell you why in this video. We will talk about Bitcoin used by criminals and that they already can be tracked by RSI, and I will talk about more about this subject. We will talk about Danish banks where courts ruled Nordea Bank can prevent employees from investing in Bitcoin. And then we will talk about central bank digital currencies and how this could be a huge threat to any one of us guys living on this planet. And this is nothing to do with Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies, but this is to do with us people who are living on this planet and how we can all be of huge victims of these central bank digital currencies which they are planning to create in future. Before I start, I wanted to talk about my videos, about my channel in general. A couple of people in comments of my videos are starting to comment that I'm not creating only cryptocurrency videos. As you can see, yesterday I posted video Mercedes C63, AMG acceleration, street racing, and so on and so forth. This is, guys, because I am not considering myself or my channel to be fully or only cryptocurrency oriented. I'm myself a programmer, guys, and in this channel I might be creating videos on programming, on web development, on different programming languages. So as guys, I am a huge car enthusiast and I also prefer posting videos on cars. Me myself, I love cars. I love everything about cars, and in future I will also planning to create a video of my own car. And if you like or if you don't like it, it is up to you whether you are interested to subscribe. However, I called my channel Crypto Bull because I'm a huge cryptocurrency enthusiast and I hope that sooner or later we will have some cryptocurrency like Bitcoin which will be independent from all governments and we will be able to use it without any huge governments or huge companies or incorporations, guys, who are controlling currently the money of the world. For example, like Federal Reserve. If some of you or most of you probably doesn't know that Federal Reserve is not a Bank of America. This is privately owned organization and which has a right to issue dollar. And they are the only one institution in the world, and not even United States government has a laws or rules over Federal Reserve. Federal Reserve is like private banks. This is means that me and you, we have a right to print all our money, in this case United States dollar and Federal Reserve, which is owned by about 10 banks. So this means that currently already in this world all money of the world is owed by private people and not by any government in the world. And that's why we are observing all these wars around the world like Iraq and Afghanistan and so on and so forth. Only because of this reason, all these huge corporations or private people, they want to owe this world in future. And this is also one of the reasons why I decided to talk about central bank digital currencies and how this can affect any person in this world. Like I said, many of you probably doesn't know that current fiat money is owed by private banks and not by governments, and not even United States government has a rules or has ability to control their own dollar. Whenever the United States wants to take money, they are taking a loan from Federal Reserve. They are taking money from private people and they are pretty much borrowing that money from those private banks, from those private people, guys, or huge corporations which control all the world, guys. And not many people know this. So guys, let's get into it and let's talk about why I think that Bitcoin is in huge danger zone. First is that we currently see a long position which is 37,736, and this is one of the hugest level already which we haven't seen in long time. If we scroll back, guys, we can see that we all these long positions are at the very top, and here we can have two scenarios. One scenario is that these long positions, and I am note guys that I am here on daily chart, and these are multiple days, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And now we are already in 15th day, or pretty much half of months, when long positions are growing. One is that these long positions, if they are created by people like you and me, and for people by people who are creating on these exchanges like Bybit, BitMEX, or for example Bitfinex or Binance, then these people will be destroyed anyway, and these long positions will be destroyed by dropping the price. And like I was mentioning in my videos, guys, I believe that all this Bitcoin market is controlled by these whales, by these organizations like Bybit, like I think, Binance, and so on and so forth. I believe that this is the case, guys. And one scenario is that they will be dropping price now, and price will be dropped in upcoming, I would say, 3-4 days. They will be dropping a price, or they will be pumping the price. So here are two scenarios. One first scenario is if they will be pumping the price, then there is some people or organizations or these people or whales who know something, and they will be pumping the price up to 9,000 to destroy, to take profits, or pretty much they have created here these long positions, they have put a long positions, and to make profits they will simply pump the price and they will take profits, and then they will dump the price, and they will dump the price only for that reason, guys, to destroy people like you and me who are in this market. And this will happen pretty much, I would say, in one day. If the price will go up, it will be one day when it will go up to 9,500 maximum, when they will take profits, and then they will push the price down to destroy people like you and me at the same day. And this is the first scenario, how I see it. And second scenario is that these longs are created by people like you and me who thinks that in future we will be going to the moon, and Bitcoin has reached now its lowest price, and now we are circulating about 7,500, guys, and that we will be going up and they will be rich. But as you know, guys, like I said, I think that this market is hugely manipulated, and if that is the case and these longs are created by people just like you and me, you think that BitMEX or Binance or Bybit and all these other huge cryptocurrency exchanges or derivative exchanges, they will allow you or me to become millionaires. Me, myself, guys, disclaimer, I don't have any positions currently. I don't have opened any long positions or any short positions. This is my only opinion what will happen. And like I'm mentioning in any of my videos, guys, my videos are not financial advice. If you are watching my videos, guys, this is only my opinion. And you should always, whenever you are trading, if you are trading, and if you are trading on these platforms, you shouldn't ever trade more than 5x leverage. But the problem is that most of people who are trading, firstly, they are trading about 20x leverage, which is huge, guys, and which to destroy 20x leverage, it takes only 5% to drop market or to go to grow market. Only 5%, and all positions will be destroyed. And second thing is that none of those people are educated traders, and they don't know that they should never ever use 20x leverage. This is another huge thing. And if even you are using a huge leverage, you should always put a stop loss. So never trade on leverage exchanges. If you do, and if you are getting into that, guys, then never trade over 5x leverage. Keep maximum 5x leverage, and you will never be able to lose if you are wrong. And if you will be correct, guys, you will be still making some money, and your entry fees in particular trade and exit fees will be much cheaper, guys. This is my advice to you if you are doing a leverage trading. But like I said, guys, first scenario is we are going up. And if we are going up, this will be a huge pump up, so these whales can take their profits, because in these longs there is also abnormal people like you and me who need to be destroyed, and they will not allow any one of us to become rich, guys. They will go up maximum to 9,500, they will take their profits, and at the same day when there will be this huge pump, there will be dump where they will dump this price, so to destroy those people who are here or leave them in their long positions, and they will be dumping price down. And in general, I think that price will be dumped, still dumped down, guys, because before next pump or before next move upside, we will anyway see a huge price drop before we continue to the bull run. So I think that most likely we will be going down anyway in the long run, and this is the next this is the second scenario how I see it. So guys, now let's move to next one. Currently, as you can see, price is 7500 and it is circulating around 7000 and 7500. It is not moving anywhere. This is pretty much now in one level. It is not going anywhere, but like I said, longs are four times more because shorts are only about 8,000 and longs are 37,742 on BitMEX, which is biggest trading platform for leverage trading. Then we move to news, guys, and Bitcoin used by criminals to evade taxes, IRS criminal investigation report 2019. And this is one of those things which I wanted to talk about, is that, for example, if you are new to this market, you are new to Bitcoin, then you should also know that all Bitcoin transactions can be tracked. Any transaction, for example, if you are making, you would ask a question, for example, how can I be tracked if I'm using a Bitcoin? So guys, you can be tracked by IP, your internet protocol, because any transaction which has been sent, it is also on blockchain registered as IP or transaction from IP from particular sender or receiver. These are IPs, and there are already companies which are used by IRS, guys, or Internal Revenue Service, which they are employing to track Bitcoin transactions on Bitcoin blockchain technology. However, there is also ways around how you can do Bitcoin mixing. However, if you are using a Bitcoin mixers and you are dealing with huge amounts, like for example, tens of thousands of dollars anyway, from Bitcoin mixers, these guys or these trackers are able to see how Bitcoin is going out or leaving these mixers with huge amounts, and at the end of the day anyway they come back into one wallet, which is the owners of wallet who has done this Bitcoin mixing. So this would not be the case for huge amounts of Bitcoin if you would be using Bitcoin mixing services. And IRS is saying that today's cyber criminals think we cannot catch them, but as evidenced by some of the great casework in this report, I would say they are wrong. They now deal in cryptocurrency, again thinking this will make them anonymous, but our agents have once again proved that there is nowhere to hide. We will not stop in our pursuit. What they are saying, if you are using Bitcoin for criminal activities, buying, selling drugs or weapons or anything like that, you can't escape from them because they can track you anyway. But like I said, guys, you can use different workarounds. However, there is also cryptocurrencies which are private cryptocurrencies, and as you have already heard, if you are long enough in cryptocurrency market, then in this year they already prohibited them in some cryptocurrency exchanges or trading platforms to deal with such cryptocurrencies like Monero, for example. If we go into CoinMarketCap and we have a look at Monero price, which is fully private cryptocurrency, and currently it has in circulation 17,344,000 and it costs $54. So you would ask yourself a question, why criminals would not use Monero rather than Bitcoin? And this is exactly the question which I would ask. Why would criminals use even a Bitcoin if they are dealing with some shady stuff or doing some shady stuff on blockchain? They would use, I would say, Monero or any other privacy coins rather than they would use Bitcoin. But the thing about Monero, if you are interested, for example, to invest in Monero and so in other privacy coins, is that in these cryptocurrencies you can't track how much cryptocurrency is on blockchain, because you don't see any transaction histories, you don't see any transactions, you can see kind of only the total supply of this particular cryptocurrency. If I like Monero, I hold some Monero, and I have invested in some Monero because I like privacy, and I kind of like the idea of privacy. Danish courts rule Nordea Bank can prevent employees from investing in Bitcoin. So Danish courts pretty much, or legal or legislation systems, had allowed Nordea Bank to prohibit their employees both from investing in Bitcoin. And this is quite not fair system if you think, guys. Why would some bank not allow their workers or employees to buy cryptocurrencies? However, this doesn't apply to other cryptocurrencies, as from this article, it doesn't apply to those cryptocurrencies or Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies these employees have invested previously before this rule came out. They can still keep those cryptocurrencies, but from now on, Nordea Bank employees can't use Bitcoin. And now let's move to the central bank digital currencies, which is the main subject which I wanted to cover in this video. However, now we are already long in this video, guys, and if you are still watching, then please put a like and let me know in comments that you have got this far. But this is one of the main subjects which I wanted to cover about central banks. If you think about money which is currently circulating in the world, then you might think that there is the same amount of physical money as it is registered in banks or on banking system, but this is not the case. In physical money, there is only 10% from all money which is actually registered and which is circulating in banking system. And you might ask, how this is possible even? How is it possible that only 10% of physical money and all the rest money is about 90% or even more, even 95%? It doesn't matter whether it's euros, whether it's yuan, whether it's United States dollars. It's the same case in any fiat money currently in the world. And that is the problem which central banks is trying to solve. For example, if you will go to your local bank and you will try to withdraw more than $5,000 or $10,000 or euros, whatever is the case wherever you live, guys, you will not be able to do it, because they will tell you that you have to write a notice that you want to withdraw more amount, and in physical money you will not be able to do it. And this is exactly because of reasons that there is not so much money. If everyone currently would go to bank and you would try to withdraw all your money all around the world, guys, all banks would go bankrupt, exactly because of reasons that there is not so much physical money, and they want to make it digital exactly because of that reason. And another reason is that this would give a full control to those who control the world. Like I said, guys, I believe, and not only like I believe, but these are facts, that Federal Reserve is owned by private banks, and this is pretty much a private bank which is used by United States government, which is borrowing money or lending money to United States government whenever United States government needs money. And United States government in exchange creates these bonds, like obligations or bonds, where they are getting these are promises that they are going to return money to this bank. But the thing is, guys, that the Federal Reserve is the institution independent from United States of America, and they are creating all rules or legal system and all legislation about how dollar will be used, how financial system will be used, what will be the interest rates. And these rules cannot be made by United States government. And you would ask, you would now be confused, hear this for the first time, how is this even possible that the United States is not controlling their own money, but some private company is controlling their money? So yes, guys, that is the case, and the same applies for you in Europe, where they are creating or trying to create the same system only from all European countries, where they are pumping in one money which is called euro, and where they are destroying or trying to destroy all national currencies from all countries which are in this European Union. This is also money control, and this is how international corporations want to control the world in the long term. And now what they are doing, they are creating digital currencies, exactly because of reason that there is not so much physical money in circulation. And you might ask, where this all other money is coming from, why there is 90%, where that 90% of money which is digital money and which is not actual real physical money, where does it come from? So here you go, guys. You are taking loans, or people are taking loans, people are buying cars, they are taking loans, people are buying apartments and houses, they are taking mortgages, people are traveling, they are taking like loans, people are borrowing money from banks, and so on and so forth. So for example, you are buying a house, and house costs only 100,000, let's say. This is, for example, like it costs only $100,000. You are taking this mortgage for 30 years, for example. There will be interest, and at the end of these 30 years, you would already pay not only 100,000, which you have borrowed, but from the bank on this mortgage, but this will cost you about 180,000. So these $80,000, they were virtually created. They were created from nowhere. They were not actually printed. And the same applies to all other mortgages, student loans, mortgages, loans you take for holidays, loans people take just like that. They all have interest rate, and that interest rate creates this huge amount of money, which makes this bubble, which creates a virtual money, which is not there. And this is the reason why they want to create these digital currencies. One of the reasons, so they don't have to give people physical money whenever they need. And imagine, financial system is controlled by already huge private corporations and private banks like Federal Reserve and so on and so forth. And they, when they create these digital currencies, which is not a cryptocurrency, this is only a digital currency, because they will not have a total supply, for example, as with Bitcoin, 21 million, and all other cryptocurrencies, other total supplies, they will not have for these digital euro total supply or digital United States total supply. They will be able still to print as much as they need. This bad thing about this is, and the bad thing for all of us people all around, that for example, if this happens, guys, we are under the control of huge corporations. We will have only a credit card, and whenever they will want to switch you off, guys, they just switch off your credit card, and you will lose all your funds. You will not be able to do anything, and all people will be fully transparent to any central bank or any bank at all, because all whatever you will be buying, whatever you will be doing, they will be able to track on your card, for example, chip, any other way where this money will be locked in, guys. And whenever you will be spending, you will be fully controlled. And if governments or someone from those highest people will not like you, they will simply switch you off. And yes, guys, this is a huger subject which I could talk about for hours, because I have been studying and researching this subject for a long time, guys, already for not only a couple of years, I'm already in this subject for about 10 years, guys. And if you're interested, let me know in comments. However, guys, this is what I wanted to cover in this video. And if you found it interesting, if you found it useful, leave a like, share this video, let me know in comments, what do you think about all this? What are your opinions, or any other comments you have? Leave them in commentary, and see you in the next one.